It's morning.
Good morning. Oh, I guess it is still morning.
Good morning to you.
Hopefully this will be up by 11 a.m. and it'll still be morning.
It's great to stay up late. Good morning. Good morning.
All right, so let's see.
Good morning. In bed with Armand and Angelina.
Happy Memorial Day. We've learned a lot about Memorial Day.
We have.
Just because Angelina did some research, and I think she's going to be sharing some of that with you today.
I think we are.
And I'm going to be learning it on the spot.
That's right.
So let's talk about our crazy shirts. This is a little bit of irony. I'd kill for a Nobel Peace Prize.
Oh,
Jerry Farber out of Atlanta, Georgia, who's a musician and comedian. I got this shirt from him, and it made me laugh. You know, it's kind of like that bumper sticker, "Death to all fanatics." I used to have that.
There are some good bumper stickers out there.
There are. We will have some bumper stickers soon. The Purple Evolution movement.
Ah, there you
Purple
go.
Evolution is going to be doing all kinds of cool things very soon. We can't tell you all about it yet, but expect awesome things to be happening sometime in June. All right, so and Angelina.
Well, this shirt we got in Paris.
It's an awesome shirt.
So it just has Paris and travel. Milan. Well, everything has New York on it. Anyway, Armand proposed to me under the Eiffel Tower.
2007. That was October of 2007.
Yeah. So I love this shirt because it reminds me of that special time in Paris and that special day when you got on your knee. He got on his knee.
Well,
under the Eiffel Tower. It was very sweet.
I was there. I didn't know if I'd ever be back. We weren't there before, and we haven't been back since.
No, we have not.
It was a very special time. I remember eating crepes on the street and going to a lot of cathedrals.
They were so good, we had to go back for more.
We did.
Too funny.
Okay.
All right, I'm messing with my hair today because I think I'm having a bad hair day. I'm just not liking it today, so sorry about that. I'll let go.
Let it go. Let it go.
Let it go.
Let your stuff about your hair
That's
go.
Right. Let it go.
The funny thing is Angelina has something that I have coined. It's a medical term. It's hairexia nervosa. It means when she looks in the mirror, she almost never likes what she sees.
Well, that is kind of true.
But
don't tell everyone that.
Angelina appreciososa. Whenever I look at you, I appreciate you.
Aww. Okay. Today's daily word is honor. It's inspired by Romans chapter 12, verse 10. I honor all who gave their lives in service to others. Memorial Day in the United States is a time to honor the men and women in the military who have made the ultimate sacrifice in service to their country. I honor the brave men and women around the earth whose service has made the world a better place. I hold them in my heart with gratitude for my freedom and my safety. I am mindful of my liberty as I remember them with respect. Their sacrifice has not been in vain. Today and every day, I honor those who have given their lives in service. I pause to reflect on the bravery and faith it takes to serve. I send gratitude to everyone for their sacrifice through actions that show my love and appreciation to those who have fallen. I will never forget those I honor today.
Oh. Scripture, love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Wow, so we can have a little competition going. Competition to see who can be the most honoring, respectful, civil. I really, I consider that a quest to learn to be as honoring, respectful, and civil, and empathetic. And I don't always get it right. And it just allows me to get it, do better. You know, it's awesome.
Well, maybe when you don't get it right and you correct it, it actually is a higher level of authenticity because you're admitting that I didn't do it exactly in the best way that I could and I want to do it better.
Yes, that's fantastic.
I don't know. All right.
I think we have a quote.
We we do have a quote.
Ladies and gentlemen, da-da-da, the quote queen.
The quote of the day. Someone told me I put this too close to the screen, so we're going to try it a different way. Okay. You will never do anything in this world without courage. It is the greatest quality of the mind next to honor.
Oh, very nice.
All right.
Alexa, good morning.
Good morning. On this Memorial Day, thank you to all of our military members who have served and sacrificed. Ask me to sing the national anthem, and I'll lift my voice for the red, white, and blue.
I don't think we'll do that.
I don't think
we don't
should
really
do that.
Know what's going to happen there, so we're not going
to. You know, I said this to some friends. Don't ask Alexa to sing a song because they're usually they're not. How do you put it, Armand? They're not my kind of songs.
You'll just have to do it and find out. They're even cheesier than we are, and that yes. is saying a whole lot.
That is saying a whole lot.
Oh, we got some new pictures there. I just noticed. So
yes,
that's approximately 1988 for both of us.
Yes,
headshots.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at that mustache.
Look how young.
Man. Probably like a porn star there.
Good hair day there, not here.
Oh my God, I have suspenders on. I don't know. Welcome to the 80s.
Oh my God, okay. Yeah. Oh my goodness. All right, well, you want to talk about a safari date?
We had such a great time on Saturday with our nephew
right.
and
before
niece.
You say that, sorry that we couldn't do this yesterday, but we just were really busy with morning Zoom, Facebook Live, Sunday services, and it was yeah. in the morning, and just
and Sundays
are hard now that yeah. we are doing more of those. So we
exactly.
You probably already told everyone that we're probably not going to be doing them on Sundays.
Probably now. Not Sundays, but it's good to be back. Serving in a more substantial way.
Yes.
Safari was great. It was about an hour and a half to drive around and see all these animals, just having fun. I mean, we've been to many safari parks. They're all over the country. If you're not a person that likes zoos, even though we are, it's a great way to spend time with animals and see them in happy, safe environments. I would rather live in a safari park than live in the wild. No predators, the best care, and very free. But we saw all these different Thompson gazelles that were bouncing like right in front of our car. Right. It was like
and one baby ostrich in the mix of all these gazelles.
Yeah, this baby ostrich liked the gazelles.
They all were on the same speed too.
And they were running around together. And of course, if you saw the video, my arm was attacked by an emu.
Yes.
Who was looking for food and somehow thought this was, you know.
You wouldn't let go.
Yeah, I called it.
That was.
I called him a bad word.
I grabbed his head, Armand's head, so that email wouldn't come in and try to get you in the face.
Yeah.
That really scared me.
I called him a bad word. I did.
Oh, you did. That's
but,
true.
But yeah, they're all over the place, and they're open, and they are very, very safe because everybody's in their car. Pretty
That's
awesome.
Right.
We've got a cool thing coming up Saturday. We're doing a live show at the North Tampa Unity Church. And we'll be setting up our stuff outside under a little awning, I believe. And then people will drive up their cars and
right.
they can roll their windows down and listen.
You know, it's like a drive-in concert. We talked about that last week, I guess,
yeah.
sometime.
And
that Keith Urban was at a drive-in theater. They put up a big stage and the cars would... So we're hanging with Keith Urban doing
so
a drive-in
anybody
concert.
Anywhere around the Tampa Bay area, and I know we have hundreds of y'all that we know from those areas. 7 p.m. this Saturday night, Unity North Tampa in Lutz.
Yes.
Reverend Virginia Walsh had this great idea, and we are excited. It's our first public appearance
yes.
since March 15th.
Yes. Okay, so we're going to do a little quiz for everyone, and Armand's going to answer. He doesn't know the answers. So, are you ready for this? It's all about Memorial Day and the history of it.
I just go with the flow, baby.
Okay. All right. So, what day of the week is Memorial Day?
It's always Monday, right?
Yes. More than 20 towns claim to be the holiday's birthplace, but in 1966, Congress declared this city to be the birthplace of the holiday. What is the city? A, Macon, Georgia. B, Richmond, Virginia. C, Christmas, Florida, or D, Waterloo, New York?
Well, Christmas, Florida would be my last choice. I'm going to say Richmond.
Waterloo, New York.
Holy shit.
Yes, but a lot of states and cities were claiming that they were where it started.
Wow, they were fighting. You know what? That's what that song by ABBA is about. Waterloo. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da, Waterloo. Do you know that?
I do know.
I just made it up.
Okay. Who do we honor on Memorial Day? A, presidents, B, bosses, C, fallen soldiers, D, the Easter Bunny.
It's either the Easter Bunny or fallen soldiers, but I'm going to go with fallen soldiers.
That is correct. Okay, in 1866...
Those were fallen soldiers that never got back up.
Okay. In 1866, townspeople and live soldiers placed flowers on the graves of fallen soldiers. Before it was Memorial Day, what was this day called? A, Peace Day, B, Remembrance Day, C, Recollection Day, or D, Decoration Day?
I'm going to go Remembrance Day.
Decoration Day, because they would put flowers on the graves.
I'm going to go with Decoration Day.
That's it. Okay, these are some true and false. True or false? Congress passed a law in 2000 that requires all Americans to stop what they are doing at 3 p.m. on Memorial Day to remember and to honor those who have died serving the United States.
It's a great idea, but I can't imagine they would pass a law that says you have to, so I'm going to say false.
It's true. I never heard of that. So
obviously, it's not well enforced.
Obviously.
Kind of like the old marijuana laws.
Okay.
Wait, that's true? Not true. That's a whole different topic. Never mind.
True or false? Congress chose the end of May because it is the perfect time of year for a picnic get-together.
I'm going to go with that.
False.
I'm dying here.
True or false? The flag is supposed to be flown at half mast until noon and then raised to full mast until sunset on Memorial Day.
That sounds true.
That is true. Woohoo!
Woo!
All right. So we learned a little bit. That's bed flossing.
Yeah, bed flossing. That's awesome. Wow, we're
all right.
We're out of time, but guess what? I would just like to say this. Since we seem to be in such a form of a civil war in this country right now, Memorial Day has something to do with the Civil War. I don't know all
it
the
does.
Details.
Do you That's have a little how bit of it started. That it was about honoring those that died in the Civil War. There
so
were
these,
like
these were Americans.
620,000.
So over
Americans
half, over half a million Americans. And the bottom line is, regardless of where you stand relative to the Civil War, you know there were two sides fighting for their beliefs, fighting for their freedom, fighting for what they thought would make America better. Hopefully, we will never do that kind of thing where we're going to be killing each other over this stuff.
Right.
But still, we can honor the people that had the courage and the passion to fight for what they believed in and realize how horrible the outcome is with Americans killing Americans. We are all on the same team, folks. We got to learn to work together. So let's all do our part.
Yes. Happy Memorial Day, and we honor all those that have sacrificed their lives for our country, and we are grateful for all that.
Let's make a funny face.